Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to cover what to expect from MSBI developer having 2 to 5 years of experience. This video is not only for the job seekers, and this is also for hiring managers, recruitment firms, that what they can expect from candidates. Let's begin. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's start understanding the skills required for MSBI developer having 2 to 5 years experience. The first and important skill is like SQL. So you are going to work in the database where you are going to implement the data warehouse using the MSBI tools. So these two skills are mandatory along with MSBI, which stands for SQL Server Integration Service, SSAS, SSRS, right? So basically, this MSBI is used to implement the data warehouse in any one of the RDBMS. Mostly in this case, it will be Microsoft SQL Server. When people are using MSBI, then their data warehouse mostly will be in SQL Server, right? So unless you know the concepts of data warehousing, you may not effectively use the tool, right? Either it can be SSIS, AS or RS, and you should have expert knowledge in SQL. So what are the different focus area you need to focus on? I will cover it in the couple of slides. Let's try to understand other things. Then you should have a knowledge in ETL tool, that is SSIS, SQL Server Integration Service. I mentioned here ADF, which is Azure Data Factory. As the organizations are moving towards Azure, you should know this tool as well. If you are very good understanding of SSIS, you do not have anything to learn or enhance your knowledge, then you can focus on ADF. If you are not at all good in SSIS, then focus on the SSIS first. Working knowledge in SSIS and SQL Server Analyst Service and good knowledge in MDX or DAX. I want to speak about here like multidimensional and tabular. So when it comes to SSIS, there are two flavors, either multidimensional or tabular. Currently, Microsoft is recommending tabular model and most of the things going towards tabular. If you're newly learning the technology, then go for tabular model. No need to worry about MDX. But those who are already in this technology, you are familiar with SSIS, and in your current organization, they have multidimensional, then learn both the things. That is my advice. And then going towards the other technology, SSRS, SQL Server Reporting Service, which is also known as Power BI Paginated Reports. So people, no need to confuse. Now in the Power BI, they have introduced paginated reports, which is nothing but SSRS. They integrated SSRS in Power BI and named it as paginated reports. So knowing this also really helpful here. Like you should at least have expert level in SQL data warehouse ETL and SSAS and SSRS, because now most of the organizations I aware of, like, they consider SSIS, SSAS, SSRS as a separate technology. People, those who are working in SSIS, not involved in SSAS and SSRS, but when the job demands all the three. So that is a sad fact. So I would like to recommend, like, if you are working in any one of the technology, try to learn other technologies, then only you have more opportunities to grow. Then finally, good to have a Power BI, as Power BI is closely related to this data warehousing and BI world, and knowing Power BI will be really helpful. So having said that, how these things will be useful in data warehouse architecture, let us give a snapshot over here. Why you need to know SQL, data warehousing concepts, all those things, I will cover it up now. So basically, the ultimate aim of data warehouse is to bring the data from the source and staging area and create a data mart or data warehouse here using a dimensional modeling. The tool used to move the data movements is SSIS, SQL Server Integration Service. So the data lies in SQL, so you need to know SQL and the concepts you should aware, so that how you will populate effectively, populate fact and dimension, how will you design your fact and dimension, then based on that accordingly you can design your SSIS package. Then you have a cubes here, SSAS SQL Server Analyst Service, the pre-aggregated layer of reporting, so your reporting time will be reduced 10x faster. So you need to have SSAS. There comes SSRS. It is not available here, but I am saying that is part of reporting layer. So all this thing together is called MSBI, Microsoft Business Intelligence. So you should know data warehousing, SQL, SSIS, SSIS, SSRS. Then only you will be a complete BI, MSBI developer. Now along with that, you should also have a knowledge on Power BI as well. Having said that, what are the different skills you require? I'm listed out here. You can take a snapshot at the end. And with respect to SQL, these are the different subject areas you need to touch upon or different concepts you may ask in the interviews, like SQL queries, joins, views, CTEs, merge statements, stored procedure, then performance tuning and index. When it comes to data warehouse, you should have knowledge on fact, dimension, types of dimensions, that is role playing, confirmed, junk dimensions, slowly changing dimensions, SCD1 and SCD2. And you might be implemented at least end-to-end data warehouse solution. When you're given a project, a requirement, you should be able to design the fact and dimensions. Then you have design, staging, SIS, everything together. Excuse me. Now, you should also have knowledge on what is granularity, what level. When you are implementing a data warehouse, then you should be aware of all these terminologies as well. When it comes to SSIS, so control flows, data flows, transformation, scheduling, troubleshooting, deployment. When it comes to control flows, execute SQL, precedence constraint, looping, execute process dot maintenance task. And in data flows, you should aware of all these kind of different transformations. What are the different source systems all together? Mainly in interviews, the question will be focused on the scenario based. So just if you are just learning the technologies, ensure that at least these things should be aware of, then the based on the interviewer, the different scenario based questions will be asked, mostly will be from these topics. Working knowledge on SSIS, like if you are worked in multidimensional, all these topics to be covered: dimension, cube creation, relationship type, measures, hierarchies, calculated member, then MDX basics to intermediate. When you are working in tabular model, then these are the topics to be covered. I mean, you should be familiar of how to import a table, how to create calculated column means what is a measure. You need to have ability to write DAX. When it comes to SSRS, the core concept in SSRS is like it is slightly different architecture than the other things like SSIS and SSAS. So you should aware of SSRS, what are the different components of it. Then you should be able to create reports, different chart types, data sets, how to parameterize report and data sets, sub-report, all those things. Then Power BI basics, as a MSBI developer, Power BI also brought in MSBI, I'm not sure, but if you have good knowledge in Power BI, then chances of getting job is really good. So you should be aware of Power Query, modeling, relationship, and how to deploy these reports. This is an overall snapshot, so you can take a screenshot. These are the different things, whatever you've seen in the entire video, have combined together in a single screen. Then last, I want to highlight, like you should also aware of other tools like SQL Server Management Studio, data tools, SQL agents. So these are the things you to obviously comes along with while you are aware of SSIS, SSAS and SSRS. Using data tools only you will develop, but I'm saying these are the tools used to build these BI solutions. Then SQL agent you should aware of, Visio to design your model, like anything you are going to design, Visio is a tool you can design, and SQL profiler. So these are some of the things you should aware of, and in your interviews the questions may be raised in these topics. Where you can learn most of the topics like SSIS, SSAS, data warehousing concept, SQL, all these things are available in the Analytics with Nags channel. We will share the description below, except the SSRS. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.